is Terry Farrell.
She gave me, get air in her lungs. She
Yes, and I thought she was joking, so I pretended to storm off the stage too. Like, standing on the side, she kept waiting for her to come back out. She doesn't come back out. So I walk back, and I give Frakes the death stare. I'm like, so mad at you, you know? And I thought I'm gonna tell
you. He must have been terrified when he did that.
No, but you know what he did do? He did eventually go back there to go talk to her. But she never came back out. And some of the people, anyone here during that time? Yeah. Yeah, see? They were here. Wasn't that crazy? You know, everyone was like, what is happening?
I'm sorry I refused two people.
Yeah, there were. Yeah, well, those guys are on that show. So, my people were like,
Oh, 2 years?
Yes.
Okay. How long did it take you to put on the makeup first?
I think it was about an hour and a half between regular makeup and spots. I just think it's my duty to give me a couple of cigarette breaks too. I don't smoke anymore. This is how I'm trying to quit, but yeah.
He basically applied those spots on you every day, freehand, right? There was no template or whatever, they all worked, right?
Yeah.
But yet they still look quite uniform, you should kind of, right? I mean, you can tell them all that stuff off, right? You memorize the place of the spots, right?
Well, yeah. It's kind of like trying the same picture over and over.
Of course.
Dr. Garrett, But it was tough for the lawsuits. I don't understand. How can you make it? There was light in the front, there was body. But it didn't look like it had been keys. It was so glossy and smooth. How can you make a suit in front of your lawsuits?
I can relieve you of that mystery.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. They would take my hair and put the front part of my hair forward and put a little piece of crepe wool right on top of my three-quarter fall, so my hair could be any length at any time. But in Star Trek land, it was always exactly the same length. So I could do a reshoot at any point during 6 years for any other show, right? But yeah, it's the crepe wool. It was really terribly hot, and my hair was shiny. I don't know, I just have shiny hair. And that used to kind of take them off because I get shiny in my head and it would look weird sometimes. Don't like spraying my hair. I'm just shiny. Yeah, thank you. And our wardrobe guy, too, be like, I put dirt on you and it falls right off.
She said glossy, it's so glossy. I heard it's so toxic.
See, you're still in the tree. I think
yes, this question.
Hi, I was just wondering if any of you guys ever had any crazy pranks pulled on you on set, or
has any other?
The moments of embarrassing things happen to us, we're not sharing those. TV show. But it's just going to be about the films.
Yes, but the information I have is that the CEO of CBS, Paramount, Les Moonves, is very anti-Star Trek. Did you hear that also?
I have not spoken to him. Like that. speaking out of my own mind. Band-Aid, a terrible combination. proceeded to have a very horrible sixth season where a lot of people were just kind of harassing me, trying to get me to sign. But by doing it in a way that would try to browbeat me so that I would feel insecure, like this is the only job on the planet for me. And I just thought, you kind of, that's kind of not healthy because I'm just thinking you're an asshole and I'm going to be such a fucking asshole.
Let me just show you.
embarrassing. I was livid. I was so mad sitting at the security office waiting for authorization to take the damn bath up to my car. So
I was never in that position.
I know. Just smiling.
No, I say hi. I'm Terry Farrell.
Oh.
Ha ha ha!
was no gay kiss.
We didn't have a reason to have a gay kiss. My gay kiss made sense.
Okay.
It was my ex-wife.
That's right.
I know, but it was even more poignant because it didn't matter that I was a female body because the Dax was still holding on by me because I love my wife.
Yes.
That was way more important than what my gender was.
I get that.
Yes. I'm trying to teach people
yes.
to love who we are inside. And I met this party, and so I meet him with my girl, and I thought, Anyway, I have a radio to sing for this time, so my audition, I was going to talk fast. I got right to work, and then that didn't work out. That was the beginning of that spring, 1992. And then, over the summer, they were reading these virtual Jonesy adapts for Star Trek Deep Space Nine, trying to build those 3 minutes. And they would see me. They would see me because they didn't think I was right. They would need for other things. And then we got to August. They still hadn't hired anyone. So they were like, could you bring her in? Her name, I'm going to go, I'm not interested now. Of course, they didn't send her to keep my house and my wife. So I went to Marina's. She told me to like make sure I, you know, have a big boobs because that's what Rick Berman liked. And so I wore this whole like girdle Madonna kind of outfit with big, and I lost about 10 pounds that week, so it looked like a stick with grapes or something. Yeah. And anyway, tons of makeup, so I was dating again. I was stuck in the 60s, and I went for it, and those girls didn't show up. I don't remember her name now. And I remember him being competitive about her, like really competitive about her. And she was kind of like, I was in the real actress fan of theater, and I thought, well, fuck her. I was like, I'm sorry.
Call them.
Call them. work with. Yeah.
I was really excited that I was, when I booked the role, that I was be working with Bobby McNeil because he was on Masters of the Universe. Masters of the Universe? I love that movie, so I was really excited about that. So stupid. Okay.
Thank you so much for coming out.
then tomorrow we'll see what we've got about the rest of the material.
Please have a seat.
Thank you, guys.